fucked in the head? Hold this for me, would ya? Okay, first arm's good.
Scanning cycle. Module. Limb. Arm. Left. Found. Location, Pavlov floor.
Could you be a little more specific?
Ew! This is terrible. It plunged into something warm and sticky. It is red polymer. Disgusting!
What does this even mean?
I am sorry, dear comrade. This is the only data I have available. I hope I managed to help you.
You sure did.
Please select the desired procedure.
Didn't see that coming.
Just woke up and I had a brilliant idea for an exhibit. Well, it's not really an exhibit. It's more like an experience. Anyway, here it is. Visitors walk into a dark room, grab a chirper, put on headphones, and hear something like... Read this, Tereshkova.
Imagine you're in a beautiful green field, surrounded by an endless forest that stretches from one horizon to the other. You hear a brook burbling nearby, birds singing, and puppies. Lots of puppies.
End recording. So, while a woman's voice is describing this landscape, some Pachellas create a holographic image of it all around them. What's the point, you ask? Well, to be honest, I don't know yet. But it's an awesome idea. I'll just have to explain why I woke up next to that Tereshkova.
I am the perfect woman. I am present. I am at peace. A flowing stream, an endless forest, a forever blue sky. In touch with my inner goddess.
Turn it off! Turn it off!
This whale's life was transferred into a polymer vessel thanks to the brilliance of Soviet scientists. Polymer mimetic adaptation owes its existence to these amazing animals. Nowadays, polymers are made to adapt inside the human body without triggering rejection, and even replace damaged organs. Research is still far from complete, but one thing is certain. This polymer whale is the first step towards the prolongation of human life.
Thanks to the talent of Soviet scientists. Still, this is a marvelous exhibit. May I ask you something, Major? If you could live on in another form after death, would you?
Nope, I like the form I've got, thanks. I don't feel like swimming around in a pool of goo.
But all in all, does the idea of polymer immortality seem acceptable to you?
Sure, why not? If somebody wants to live like that, I say let them.
You're not exactly an optimist, are you, Major?
Not anymore.
Here's an interesting fact. This whale was obtained by Mikhail Stockhausen, who piloted a whaling vessel for an entire week.
I really couldn't care less, Charles. What's that crap in the canisters?
Be careful. That is a specimen called Plush, or Ivy. It is extremely dangerous.
Yeah, I've seen this crap before. And of course, the ripped-off arm is in there too. Why couldn't it just be lying in a corner somewhere? Thank you.
Please select the desired procedure.
What's that crap in the canisters?
Be careful. That is a specimen called Plush, or Ivy. It is extremely dangerous.
Yeah, I've seen this crap before. And of course, the ripped-off arm is in there too. Why could it just be lying in a corner somewhere?
Thank you.
authorization. Major Nechayev, codename P3, access granted.
Saving data.
Please select the desired procedure.
What's that crap in the canisters?
Be careful. That is a specimen called Plush, or Ivy. It is extremely dangerous.
Yeah, I've seen this crap before. And of course, the ripped-off arm is in there too. Why could it just be lying in a corner somewhere? Thank you. What's that crap in the canisters?
Be careful. That is a specimen called Plush, or Ivy. It is extremely dangerous.
Yeah, I've seen this crap before. And of course, the ripped-off arm is in there too. Why couldn't it just be lying in a corner somewhere?
Mm-hmm.
son of a bitch almost took me out. Let's hope another one of those freaks doesn't come crawling out of the next canister.
According to my data, the second canister is sealed properly.
Infiltrated the VDNH yet, Major? The government commission is almost here.
I'm inside, looking for a way to activate military drill mode. Things have been complicated by a shitload of weird shit. Any more questions?
Oh, look faster. Don't let Dr. Sechenov down again.
Speaking of weird shit. Thank you. Charles, so after the whole beta connector idea was dead, they made the neuro connectors with discretionary authority?
I'm afraid so. The power struggle in the Kremlin will never end. The party elite insisted on having power even within Collective.
Well, they're our government, right? We're the USSR.
Indeed we are. But Collective was designed to be for everyone on Earth, and the USSR is not the only country.
We can't let capitalists and imperialists into Collective.
Why not? Collective was designed as a worldwide union for equal human beings, where robots will do everything for them. Everyone will have the same opportunities.
The capitalists won't like the sound of that.
Unfortunately, no one in power will see equality as an appealing prospect. So to avoid being crushed by the Kremlin, Dr. Sechenov programmed discretionary authority into Collective.
I see. Here's your left arm. Go ahead, fix yourself up.
Scanning the exhibition area. Module head found. Establishing coordinates.
Shit, it's dark here. I got a bad feeling about this.
The Neptune Complex is an underwater city that has been located at the bottom of Lake Lazur since 1944. The complex is a one-of-a-kind research facility. Building up. The Neptune Complex is an underwater city that has been located at the bottom of Lake Lazur since 1944. The complex is a one-of-a-kind research facility whose primary task is working with special water plants used in the production of polymers. The structure of the complex and the unprecedented precision of its design impressed the world's engineering community so much that in 1954, international investors asked Soviet specialists to build another underwater. Access granted.
Crispy fucking. Where's the shit ass way out of here? Underground or something?
Thank you. Fuck me. Where am I supposed to find the head?
You need to enter Icarus Hall. It is located on the second story of this venue.
So where's the entrance?
Unfortunately, I do not have this information. Everything's got mixed up after the malfunction.
No shit, Sherlock.
Have you considered powering the Beluga?
How is that supposed to help?
I don't know. It's just a suggestion.
Well, I guess it can't hurt to try. It's not like we've got a lot of other options. Tereshkova, where's the power room around here?
At the very top.
Fantastic. So cut off. Just what I always wanted.
Watch out!
Thank you.
So, what was wrong with the real beta connectors?
Since Collective was originally planned without any discretionary authority, everyone in it was supposed to be equal.
Yeah, we already talked about that. Then why'd they need the beta connectors?
To secure Collective against unforeseen threats from individuals who might wish to control it.
That's impossible. Everybody's equal in Collective. Shit, the Alpha connector.
Indeed. Intruders, or an opposition force among equals, could try to obtain the Alpha connector. This could lead to human casualties, which would be unacceptable.
So how could beta connectors stop this from happening?
They didn't give their carriers... discretionary authority, but they did allow them to be present within Collective without being a part of it. In other words, they had total autonomy while retaining access to the information network.
So what? That's basically what we have right now.
You're seeing this from a human perspective.
What other kind of perspective could I... Oh, crap. The boss wanted to put beta rings on some robots so no one else in Collective could control them.
Indeed they are. At first, Dr. Sechenov planned to order his loyal twins to guard the Alpha connector. While logged into Collective, he could control them from anywhere on Earth. At the same time, no one else would be able to give them orders. They wouldn't even know that they exist.
Hold on, Charles. I don't quite get it. Would it be possible to launch Collective with everybody equal, then destroy the Alpha connector?
Certainly, but that begs another question. Who would choose to do that?
Dr. Sechenov.
Are you sure about that, comrade?
So where's the very top?
Thank you. The mind leads us.
That's 2 rubles and 75 kopecks.
This is where the power comes from.
Are you sure?
Definitely.
How?
Because this place has my favorite thing in the whole fucking world. A relay.
Really? I thought you were more partial to canisters.
Oh, come on.
Fading data.
So, what will it be, Major? Weapons or ability? Will it be, Major?
see if this thing helps.
Did it?
Oh, yeah. Right. What do we have here? Tereshkova, do you copy?
Yes, dear comrade. The communication is restored.
So, where's that head of yours?
My head is where it's supposed to be, but Claire's head should be somewhere on your floor. Like I said earlier, something is crushing it with terrible force, like a migraine, like an excavator, like an entire mountain.
I get it. I really do. All your whining is giving me a migraine, too. I'll go look for it. Looks like a maze for kids. This'll be a cakewalk. Jumpy little thing, ain't ya? How do I rotate you, huh? Hey, I think I get it. Now we're getting somewhere.
Do you have any idea what you're doing, Major?
Just a sec.
Is it really that difficult?
Crispy goddamn fucking critters! Yeah! Gotcha! Nice! Easy.
When warmth and beauty mingle, at the path's turn, a carcass lay asprawl upon a bed of shingle. Legs raised like some old whore, far gone in passion. The burning, deadly, poison-sweating mass opened its paunch in careless, cynic fashion. Ballooned with evil gas. On this putrescence, the sun blazed in gold, cooking it to a turn with eager care. So to repay to nature hundredfold what she had mingled there, the sky, as on the opening of a flower, on the superb obscenity smiled bright. The stench drove at us with such fearsome power.
Yes, found the head. We gotta keep moving. Charles, any idea how much time we got left?
I cannot say for sure, but definitely not much.
Finally, I got all her parts. Right. Installing the head. All her body parts assembled. What now?
Self-repair procedure complete. I am ready for service.
Thank you, comrade. We will now initiate the launch sequence.
First launch code sequence generated. Please confirm that launch code sequence is matched.
Second launch code sequence generated. Launch code sequences match. Initiating BDNH mode of operation change. New mode, military drill.
Whew, I think we made it. Thanks, ladies.
Thank you, dear comrade.
Please, Comrade Molotov, I beg you. It's not safe here.
So it's still dangerous. I was told everything was under control.
There was a minor issue, but Major Nechaev, forgive me, Agent P3, has already dealt with it.
What exactly did he deal with? There's blood all over the place.
That's not blood. It's paint.
Comrade Sechenov, you're playing a dangerous game here.
Greetings, Comrade Molotov. I don't follow you. What game?
You know what I'm talking about, Comrade Sechenov. Your local malfunction is actually a worldwide catastrophe. Your robots in combat mode. Countless human casualties. Need I go on?
Oh, please do. But first I'd like to know how you obtained this information.
From Viktor Vasilievich Petrov, your engineer, an outstanding roboticist, an honored citizen of the Soviet Union.
That's what he used to be. Now he's prisoner number 230385, sentenced to community service at the Vavilov complex.
By your order, you are in direct violation of Soviet law. As a minister, the Minister of Industry, you know the consequences. Here is the Procurator General's decree. The upcoming launch of the Collective Neural Network will be canceled, and you'll be the subject of a full-fledged investigation. Am I making myself clear, Comrade Sechenov?
Comrade Molotov, may I have a word with you in private?
Do you really think that's going to change anything? Fine. I'll meet you here in 15 minutes.
Mikhail, meet me at the landing pad.
Right away, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Go ahead. Aren't you in a hurry to see your master, Major? Stockhausen seems awfully eager. Is something wrong, Major? Major, I asked you a question.
Lock the door.
What's going on?
I said lock the door.